supply means quantity of a commodity offered for sale in the market by a firm at a point of time and at a fixed price. So this is called supply. So supply means quantity of commodity offered for sale in the market at a particular price by a firm. We can also say that. So this supply is from producer side. Supply is from producer side and demand is from consumer side. We should always know that. Supply is from producer side. Right? See, then the next topic is that factors affecting supply. Right. There are five factors we can tell, we can explain about five factors. These five factors are very important on which supply depends. Right. Price, the first factor on which supply depends or which determines supply is the price. If the price is higher in the market, then supply will increase of the product. Because my dear student, you know, there is a direct relationship between price and supply. If the price will increase, supply will increase. If the price will fall, supply will fall. Price of related goods. Then price of related goods also affect the supply. Right? If the price of a particular good increases, right, demand of that particular good increases, then what happens, you know, all the producer will start producing that product only. For example, there are three firms, A, B, C, making, you know, a similar product, or you can say identical product, right? Or you can say product, similar product, which are different in somewhat in type of quality or other things. Right, shape, color, size, etc. If the demand of C good increased, then the demand of A and B will fall, or definitely. So what happened? Consumer will start purchasing C good. Has started purchasing C good, right? So what happened? The other two firm, they will also start making the C type of product because it's demand is more in the market and then supply of that product will increase, right? So the price of related good also affects the supply. If the supply of C good increases in the market, right, because A and B are substitutes, then what happens, my dear student, other firms will also start making C goods because its demand is more in the market, so its supply is more. So the other two firms will also start making the C product. They will also start supplying the C type of product, right? So this is the thing. Price of input. If the price of inputs increases, then supply will fall short. If the price of inputs decreases, then supply will, you know, fall. So price of input also affect the supply. If the price of inputs increases, then supply will fall. If the price of input decreases, then supply will increase. Because a firm will have cheaper cost of production because input price are less. Firm is getting benefit of less price and their profit will rise and its profit will also rise. So price of inputs, technology is another thing. If the technology increases, then the supply will also increase. Otherwise, vice versa. Now, government policy, taxation. You know, if government is, you know, encouraging production of some product, then what happened? The supply of that product will increase. Or suppose government decreases taxes on that product, then supply of that product will increase in the market. But if the government, you know, increases tax इसका दिस मीन्स दैट गवर्नमेंट हैज़ रिजेक्टेड द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ यू नो दैट प्रोडक्ट एंड दैट इज़ वाई इट हैज़ इम्पोज हैवी टैक्सेज ऑन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ दैट गुड दैट इज़ कॉल्ड यू नो गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी एंड टैक्सेशन सिस्टम सो इंक्रीज इन दैट रेट ऑफ टैक्सेस ऑन ए प्रोडक्ट विल हैम्पर इट्स सप्लाई बट डिक्रीज इन द टैक्सेस ऑफ द डिक्रीज इन द टैक्सेस ऑफ ए प्रोडक्ट विल यू नो माई डियर स्टूडेंट इंक्रीज सप्लाई सो देन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज लॉ ऑफ सप्लाई टू नो द लॉ ऑफ सप्लाई law of supply state it is said that if other things remain same as price rises supply rises otherwise versa there is direct relationship between supply and price supply and price now we can prove it with the help of table and diagram table price to supply Now you see, according to the table, price is when price was rupees 2, supply was 4. As price increased to 4, supply becomes 8. This is the law of supply. Law of supply state, as price will rise, according to Tabular diagram, when the price is rupees 2, initial price is rupees 2 and supply is 4. As price rises to rupees 4, supply immediately becomes 8. Why? Because there is a direct relationship between price and supply, and producer or the producer or business firm wanted to utilize this opportunity to maximize their profit. That is why the supply immediately rose up due to rise in the price. This is called as, you know, my dear student, you know, law of supply. So law of supply states positive relationship between supply and you know, price. So then the next topic arises here. Afterwards we have contraction in supply and expansion in supply. We discuss over contraction in supply, and you know, my dear student, expansion in supply. Now these both activities are affected by law of demand. Law of demand applies here. Law of demand applies here. So we can also explain it with the help of table and diagram. We can explain it with the help of table and diagram. Now see, extension in supply and contraction in supply. Extension in supply means first profit. So it shows direct relationship between supply and price. We can prove it with the help of table and diagram. Price, table, supply, price 2, supply 4, price became 4, supply becomes 8. See, as table, right, table. price supply. According to table and diagram, when the initial price was rupees 2, supply was 4. As price rises to rupees 4, supply becomes 8. Law of demand apply here. Positive relationship between demand and supply. Then contraction in supply. Is just opposite to it. Contraction in supply just opposite it if other things remaining same as price falls. Supply also falls. Table. Price 2. Supply PS. Right. According to table and diagram, right, as price falls, supply also falls. As price falls, supply also falls because there is a direct relationship between price and supply. So, my dear student, this is extension and contraction supply. In the next video, I will make one more video on this topic, and then last I will cover up simple application of demand and supply. That is chapter 10. Producer equilibrium and market equilibrium is not in your syllabus this year because it has been deducted, right, by the CBSE board due to the online classes. That is why we are making video for you. So we'll discuss about the my dear student, one more topic is there. That is called increase in supply and decrease in supply. And in the last topic, chapter 10, we will discuss from it. Okay, thank you. Good day. Goodbye. Yes. Now, my dear student, this is my second video on this topic, supply and elasticity of supply. So, increase in supply is the next topic. And then, increase in supply. Right. We are going to study right now, increase in supply. There are two situations of increase in supply. That is called high price but supply is same. Right? High supply but price is same. There are two reasons. First reason is high price, supply is same. Second reason, high supply but price is same. Table and diagram. Table and diagram. So we can prove it our point with the help of table and diagram. So there are both situations shown in the two diagrams and two tables. Now see, in the first table, according to first table, we are taking the situation of high price but supply is same. High price but supply is same. Price is 2. Price is 2. Supply is 4 initially. Right? As soon as price rose to rupees 2, supply becomes same. Supply remains same. That is, you can see the diagram. Price is rising up but supply remain constant or fixed. Price move from 2 to 4 and supply can move from E to E from E point. Same level, same points are there on the same curve. Supply is totally fixed or constant. Right? Supply will not budge an inch. So my dear student, this is the case of increase in supply, first part. Second part is high supply, but supply is price is same. We can also prove it with the help of table and diagram. Now, price. Price is fixed here in this situation. Only supply is increasing, right? Supply has increased, right? From 2 unit to 4 unit, right? So, here the price is constant in the diagram, only supply has increased from 2 to 4 supply, right? So, why this happened? This happened because of, my dear student, other factors. Other factors are responsible, not price, right? Like change in weather. These factors are change in weather, change in season, change in climate, right? Change in size of population, change in fashion, taste and habit. These are the causes of applicability of increase in supply. So, my dear student, I tell you once again, this topic, this increase in supply is not affected by law of supply. It is affected by other factors like change in season, change in fashion, taste and habit, change in culture, change in size of population, change in weather, change in climatic conditions. Right. So these are the things which have been change in size of taxes, change in size of taxes, right, taxation policy of India. So these are the causes of increase in supply, right? So its second part is decrease in supply. So decrease in supply, I will draw here. That is low price, but supply is same. Low supply at same price. Low price and same supply, right? We can change the arrow. I am changing the arrows. So, my dear student, it refers to two situations, right? It refers to two situations, that is, you know, low price and same supply. First case is low price and same supply. Here the price is, you know, 4 and 2. Two prices are shown in the table and supply is 4. Fixed. Supply is fixed. So, this type of situation occurs due to other factor, right? Right? Sometimes change in season, if suppose my dear student, if we change weather, change from warm to cool, right? In India we have weathers, right? Sometimes we have spring, sometimes we have rainy season, sometimes we have very hot type of climate, then cool climate is also there, right? So in winter, what happened? The demand of woolen cloth increases and the cloth belongs to cotton. Their demand falls and their price also falls, but supply does not rise. supply remain fixed. Right, C. So here also the same condition, if the same condition will persist, right, what happened? My dear, supply, you know, remains same, price falls, but demand also remain same. Because some people do purchasing in off season of clothes, right, to meet their demand of wearing the clothes in next season, that is a warm season,
hot season,
right? So that is why. So because they got the benefit of low price, but so that is the benefit goes to the consumer. So here low price, according to table and diagram, initial price was rupees 4, supply is 4. As soon as price falls, supply should fall, but supply has not fallen because it is not affected by law of demand. Four. Then we can say low supply but price is same. Table and diagram. Four and two. Right, see. Initially, you know, my dear student, price is here remain fixed in the second case, that is 4-4. But my dear student, supply has fallen. Supply has fallen. Initially price was 4 and supply was 4. As soon as price remains the same, but supply falls to 2 units. Right? Why this happened? Because it is change in weather, change in size of population, change in fashion taste and habit. These are the major causes of change in taxation policy of the government. These are the major causes of decrease in supply. So these are the two cases of increase and decrease in supply. Then last topic of this chapter is elasticity of supply. Right? We can go to the elasticity supply. It refers to percentage change in supply due to percentage change in. It refers to percentage change in supply due to percentage change in price. So formula is price elastic demand and elastic demand, percentage change in quantity supplied, percentage change in price. Degrees and types of elastic demand. It is also called as elasticity supply, or the better part I should write here, supply as. Right, see. Now, elastic supply, the formula depends on percentage in quantity supplied, percentage in price. It has 5 types. It has 5 degrees. Number first, types of elastic supply. It has 5 types. Number first, perfectly elastic supply. Perfectly elastic supply. That is PES is equal to infinity. PES is equal to infinity. Right. And in this situation, right, price will remain fixed, supply may increase and decrease up to any extent. It refers to change in supply. When change in supply, when price remain fixed, and price below that point cannot decrease. If the price will decrease, then there will be no supply. Supply will become zero. So that is called elasticity of supply. We can show with the help of table and we can show with the help of diagram. Here price P. X supply. PES is equal to infinity. Write C, price 0, price, this is the initial supply, this is the supply may decrease, may increase, but price will not, price cannot fall from OP because it is a minimum price. It is minimum price, and if price has fallen from this point, then all factories, all business firm will shut down because they were in total loss, and no producer want to attain loss, my dear students. So there are three situations in which we can show that supply is increasing, and other situation supply is decreasing. This is shown by E1 and E2 point, but you know, price will not change its position. It is fixed, constant. So this is first case. Then let us come to the second case, that is called, my dear student, you know, second part, perfectly inelastic supply. Now in this situation, my dear student, price increases or decreases, but supply remains fixed. Hence, PS here is equal to 0. Table. Take a price, supply. Table. Price 4, 2. Supply is fixed. This is right. Supply is fixed. So, supply is fixed. Only price will increase or decrease. But supply will not, P1, price may fall, may rise, but supply will not increase or decrease. This situation is known as, you know, perfectly elastic supply. Only price is increasing or decreasing, but supply is fixed. Next case. Right, there is unity elastic supply. It refers to a situation in which percentage change in price is equal to percentage change in supply. Percentage change in price is equal to percentage change in supply. Its PS here is equal to 1.
my dear student,
PS is equal to 1. Right, see, my dear student, here price may, as much as price falls, supply will also fall. Law of demand applies. If price will rise by 10%, supply will also rise by 10%. If price will fall by 10%, supply will again fall by 10%. So in this case, as much as percentage change in price will occur, the same percentage change in supply will also occur. We can prove it with the help of a diagram. This is diagram SS, right? Now see, third case, it is third case, I beg your pardon. Now see, here, this is unitary elastic supply. Right, we call it unitary elastic supply. Fourth case, right, less elastic supply. It means, percentage change in price is more, but percentage change in supply is less. It means percentage change in price is more, but percentage change in supply is less. It means PS is equal to PS less than 1. PS less than 1. Because percentage change in supply is less than the percentage change in price. So my dear, we can prove it with the help of one more table and diagram. Right here, this supply curve is, my dear student, is sloping in a what direction? P, Q, O, S. Now you can see in the diagram, percentage change in price is more, but percentage increase in demand is very, very less. Now see, this is price, this is supply. X, Y, X, Y. Now see, in this case, we can see price, initial price is OP and supply is OQ. As price rises to P1, supply increases, but increase in supply is less in comparison to price. Right, so this is known as price less elastic supply, or relatively less elastic supply, we can also call it. Lastly, more elastic supply, last more elastic supply, right, means percentage change in supply is more than the percentage change in price. Here PD is equal to P is more than 1. Means it means percentage change in supply will be more. Percentage change in supply will be more, rather than percentage change in price. If price will fall, then there will be more fall in supply. If price will rise, then there will be more rise in price. We can show it with the help of diagram. Now see, this is the case. Here you can see percentage change in price is very less. Price increases from P to V1 and supply increase from Q to Q1. But see, the increase in supply is more, right? So hence PES is equal to 1. PES is equal to 1. So my dear students, these are the 5 cases of elastic demand. The last topic is today, mine is demand and supply tools. Simple application of demand and supply tools. That is last topic. 2 diagrams are there. So those topics are related with the price ceiling and price flooring. So today I will discuss these 2 topic and then I would be able to close the syllabus of microeconomics. Microeconomics syllabus would be completed of class 11.